Hydrogen and information technology industry. In fact, a few questions were given by Dr. Sasmita when my name was in some other panel, but I thought I will give have a few answers to that basic questions. Why is gender equality important to a responsible business? Equality for women is to the benefit of all. And no country can reach its full economic potential and achieve widespread prosperity if half of its population cannot participate fully in the economy. And gender equality matters because women can bring money home, which empowers them financially and also socially. And also, if women have a bigger say in how household money is spent, this can ensure more of it is spent on children, which results in better outcomes for their children. Besides, in India, giving power to women at local government level, we have seen that it has led to increases in public services such as water and sanitation. So wherever women are there, the quality of services are likely to improve. This is what I basically want to say. At home also, if two people are earning, if both men and women are working, then the prosperity and the quality of life is different as compared to the families where there are single earners. And the stress level also of the single earner is more when women are also working in the family. So similarly, at the country level also, at the national level also, when both men and women are working and participating in work, then the quality of life and the level of development will be different. Another question was, what is required for a sustained drive to end inequality? This will require addressing multiple and reinforcing barriers to equality among families, job, and product market. First of all, I have written families. And in my research finding also, I will talk about that later. Here, the first step would be to improve the access for girls' education. The second step would be to address market and institutional failures that lock women into low return and highly vulnerable forms of employment. The third step will be to address the violence against women and girls. And because this violence is prevalent, girls and women, they don't want to go to such offices where they are working on odd hours. And in rural area and in tribal area, girls are not going to school. Parents are not sending their girl children to school because this violence against women is so much. And a fourth step will be to address structural weaknesses in police and judicial systems which deny women access to justice and render law ineffective. So these are the four steps, but they appear simple, but they are not so simple. And in last, the panelists in the last session were discussing about it, and after that now I am coming on the study and findings of which I am going to present with all of you. IT and gender equality. The need of providing equal opportunities to women was felt first of all in North America in 90s, and as most of India's leading IT BPO companies were closely working with large global companies, they also became part of implementation of their gender inclusivity policies. And this is why IT BPO companies have been among the first to realize the impact of gender inclusivity on business success. On the other hand, the disadvantages of odd working hours, exploitation, insecurity, lower salary, displacement from service when pregnant, discrimination in promotion, etc. They are the problems which women in IT sector are facing, and they are needed to be explored. There is huge potential in IT sector for everyone and especially for women. this sector in this industry and service sector has given a lot of opportunities to women, and so much of employment is generated for women in this sector. And this is first time in history. In agriculture, when mechanization came, then women were displaced from the work, and they were and in industrial sector also, with increase in mechanization, women were displaced. But IT has given them opportunity to work in good environment and in good working environment, and also it is generating employment in large numbers. The IT sector is growing at 7.5% of gross domestic product, and in 2017 this percentage was 7.7. This industry in India is likely to reach $2.5 trillion by 2020. India remained the world's top sourcing destination in 2016-17 with a global share of 55%. Indian IT and IT-enabled services companies have set up over 1,000 global delivery centers in over 200 cities around the world. The main reason behind this phenomenal growth in India's cost is India's cost competitiveness in providing IT services, and the cost is approximately 3 to 4 times less as compared to the cost of US companies. This huge potential is there for everyone in IT sector. But let us see how inclusive this industry has been. If we make an assumption that access to computers is empowering, then 80% of the Indian people who do not have access to computers and who do not have good enough English education for computer use will not be considered as empowered. The second point is that the exclusion of majority of Indian population from the information age raises questions about politics and culture of software that are important not only to India but to the entire world. Gender inclusivity in IT sector, we can see that the number of working women in India is highest in the world. Out of total working population of approximately 4 million, 30 to 35% are women. Out of these women, a large number is working in unorganized rural areas. Only 20% work in urban areas, and a very small fraction of which works in organized sector. Out of this who are working in organized sector, some are whatever is the number of educated English speaking working women in urban area, it is largely due to the growth of IT BPO industry, which is one of the largest recruiters of qualified workforce in recent times in private sector. To discuss the social the objectives of the study were to discuss the socio-economic profile of women in Indian IT industry, to analyze the problems faced by women in Indian IT industry which are detrimental to the industry's inclusive growth from gender perspective, and to make suggestions for making the Indian IT industry more and more gender inclusive. The methodology used in this study is based on primary data, and this data were collected through questionnaires from 200 women working in IT industry in Mumbai city. For selecting the respondents, non-probability sample method was used, and women were selected randomly from various firms functioning in IT sector at different levels. The data were analyzed using SPSS, simple statistical tools like percentage, average, chi-square, regression, correlation, etc. were used, and the data were presented in the form of charts and table. The main findings of the study are that out of 200 sample women working in IT sector, 80% work in the age group of 21 to 30. 9% were even below the age of 21, and only 11% women were above the age of 30 years, out of which only 2 women were above the age of 40 years. This shows the preference of the employers for giving jobs to younger women. So, second, socio-economic background. Out of socio-economic background, the second finding is that 68% women were unmarried, which shows that women with family responsibilities are less inclined to take up employment in IT sector, as the pressure of work seems to be high due to time-bound projects, and this also suits to the employers. The sample working women were highly educated and they possessed degrees like B.Tech, BE, MCA, MTA, ME, BSc, IT, CA, MBA, PhD, Master in Finance, etc. But 70% of the respondents also had non-technical degrees, but still they were working in IT sector. Now here we can see the designation at which level these women are working. 46 women, which that is 23%, they are working at trainees level. Team members are 107, team leaders are 29, project leader 9, senior project manager 9, and director and above 6. So this was the levels at which these women are working. So we can clearly see that the entry level number is comparatively very high in IT sector. Marital status and family support, if we see whether these women, they have support of their families, we can see that 78 out of 200 women, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is like excellent support, good support, okay support, that way. But I have worded it like this: family has given me full freedom to pursue my career and do not have any expectations from carrying out domestic responsibility. This is like excellent support from the family. 78 women said that they are getting this type of support, out of which 58 were unmarried and 9 were married. So marriage also has to do something with increase in responsibilities, domestic responsibility. Family has given me freedom to pursue my career and helps me to carry out domestic responsibility. This is like a very good support from the family. 63 unmarried women said that they are getting this type of support, and 26 married women, they also are getting this. So 89, that is the largest number of women who are getting this second type of support from their families. Third is, family expects me to compromise at my workplace for carrying out domestic responsibilities. 11 women even said that. 6 women said that family wants me to quit the work for carrying out domestic responsibilities. And 16 women said that family wants me to work because I am earning, but they are showing nagging behavior when it comes to bearing the domestic responsibilities and carrying out the domestic responsibilities. So after that, I also asked them questions about how much support they are getting in their office. This question was separately asked: what kind of support they are getting from the juniors and what kind of support they are getting from the from their employers and seniors. But I have combined total office support in this table, and in office, 40 women say that the overall office support, overall office is very considerate, and 100 women say that it is good. 38 women say that the office support is okay. One person only says that it is bad. 15 women say that they cannot say anything about what kind of support they are getting in office from their juniors as well as seniors. And 12 women say that it differs from person to person. If you are good with others, then you are getting good support. But if you are not good with them, then you are not getting proper support. So this kind of responses also were there. But in general, we can say that 140 women clearly say that they are getting good support in office, in their working, at their working places. Why they started working, why they are working, this also, this finding also is very important. 23 women said that financial compulsions are there because of which they started working, but 105, they are working because they have career aspirations, and 73 they want to have their own identity. So it's not that women are working because of financial compulsions only, but because they want to have their own identity and they have career aspirations. Because of that, most of the women are working because of that. Financial compulsion is only 23. Family pressure is 10. Any other is 2. So are women attaining their full potential?
Yes, just family pressure and having chairperson pressure.
Yes.
Please, we need to wind up.
It is just about to be over. So are women attaining their full potential? 166 women said that yes, they are attaining their full potential, but 31 who said that they are not attaining, they have given reasons. What are the reasons? 24 out of that said that there exists a glass ceiling. So there are women who are accepting that there is a glass ceiling, and because of which they are not able to get higher positions in their office. But all 31 said that due to family responsibilities, women themselves are not taking up higher level posts. And 17 said that women do not possess necessary capabilities which are required for higher positions. 17 women were women like that, and they are all highly qualified. And these all women are brought up in city like Mumbai. They are highly qualified, they are working in IT sector, and still they feel that there are some women who don't have capabilities. And there is gender discrimination. 10 women said talked about gender discrimination also in providing the career opportunities to perform higher roles. And voluntary attrition of working women due to marriage, children or relocation, that response also was there. And no security on odd hours. Only 3 women said that they don't feel secure because odd hours are there, so they don't want to take up higher level posts. Gender inclusivity, this is the last table, madam. I asked them what they understand by gender inclusivity, what is their perception, and what aspects they feel that why they feel that in their company gender inclusive environment is there. So large number of women are employed in this company. 51 women said that out of 200. And that is how they feel that the company, in the company environment is gender inclusive. Anti-sexual harassment norms are in place in the company. But the largest number is 108 who said that all the applicable social security benefits are provided to men and women on par. So 101 women felt that there is gender inclusion, and this is this aspect they give, they found very important from the point of view of gender inclusion. And they said that gender inclusive environment they are finding in their companies. Women are generally employed on permanent basis, and then some women said about flexi leave policy, flexi hours, transportation facility and all that. But in general, we can understand that most of the women found that in their companies, the environment is gender inclusive. Conclusion, when we consider that percentage of these educated women, both married and unmarried, from the educated, career-oriented families staying in most modern city of Mumbai, who are getting fair support from their families in pursuing their career is so less, it shows that patriarchal mentality of even this strata of the society is yet to change. And instead of sharing all the conclusion, the last point I want to emphasize, and in last session also madam was talking about it, overall it can be said that urban educated working women are facing more problems at home rather than at workplace. So first the mindset should change at home and working places. At least we can see a good picture in IT industry. In other industries it may not be so good, because there number of women are not so many and their facilities are not so good and they are not growing at that pace. But still, at least there is some hope, some ray of hope. We can say that if this trend is followed in other industries also, then a good working environment can be there for women. But at home, the mindset is yet to change. Because in for this strata of women also, we are getting answers from them that at family people say that you don't work or you there is nagging behavior when it comes to bearing their domestic responsibilities. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr.